And now to a very special woman doing her part to help fellow sufferers of a rare disorder. Today, national correspondent Amy Robach has her story. Amy, good morning.
Good morning to you, Natalie. About 4 million people in this country deal with alopecia areata. It's an autoimmune condition which causes significant and, in some cases, complete loss of hair all over the body. I met up with one woman with alopecia who has traveled the country on a mission to help others like her by doing something as simple as lunch.
Well, I would say about 13 years ago, that was the time when my hair started falling out all over my head, lost my body hair, lost my eyebrows.
For Thea Chasson, the onset of alopecia meant some big changes in her life.
What is that like for a woman, specifically, to realize I'm losing all of my hair and it's not growing back?
In our society, there's so much emphasis on how we look. So when a woman loses her hair, she's really facing the mirror and having a whole new self-image.
Since 2005, Thea has traveled to 33 cities, bringing together hundreds of women with alopecia at supportive gatherings, known simply and irreverently as Bald Girls Do Lunch. I joined one recently at Maggiano's restaurant in Oak Brook, Illinois.
I still think most people have never heard of alopecia areata. They look at you like, what?
We're not sick.
No, and right. People want to know. Well, why are you bald if you're not sick? And I'm at a loss of words.
What do they say to you when they come up to you?
They assume you have cancer.
Exactly.
It's fairly common. A lot of people have it in the U.S. Up to 2% of the population has it. And not everyone has it in the full degree that we all do, because most of us...
Well, I'm a little different. I have a lot of hair left, but it... You can call me Patches because it's really patchy. I mean, I can grow a nice mohawk, but that's just not the look I'm looking for.
What did that feel like when it started to fall out? I mean, how do you describe it?
Well, I thought I was dying.
I think it's the worst thing ever, the transition of losing your hair. Because you go through all of the stages of grief, I think.
Mm-hmm.
You're sad, you're angry, you feel sorry for yourself. You know, you're just beside yourself.
Yeah. Eventually, my doctor, he's like, I think you have alopecia, and sent me to a dermatologist, and she's like, you'll love this. She's like, here's a pamphlet. There's nothing we can do for you.
It's a little frightening at first. Then you start to really adjust and realize everybody here is fine. They have families. We have great careers. We're smart women. We're all beautiful, and it's made a big difference for me.
In what environments do you feel comfortable taking the wig off? And are you comfortable anywhere? I know, obviously, maybe
obviously,
you are.
I tried wigs in the very beginning when I lost enough hair to where I couldn't cover up the patches anymore, but it just didn't work for me. And so what I ended up doing was
eventually going to get
my head shaved. For the first time, I went to a barbershop, and it was still a very emotional moment in my life. And so after that, it was still a while before I came out in public. But once the weather warmed up, and see, I'm from Texas, Houston, Texas, and when it gets warm, it gets warm. And I was like, okay, I gotta come out of these.
My first Bald Girls Lunch was last November, and I was like not accepting of myself at all. And then this was like the first time in public that I had actually taken my hair off. And after that, I was just like, you know what? It's okay. I'm gonna be okay, and I can do this. And you know, who cares, you're bald.
In fact, one of the benefits for the ladies at this particular lunch is trying on new looks.
Okay.
Nice with the highlights.
I know you're very upfront with the people when you first meet them.
Yes, I do.
I believe you told a guy on your first date, correct?
I did, yes, and he completely freaked out. Completely freaked out. And I will tell you that he had bad teeth, and I did not judge that against him. Let me just say that very clear. He's listening.
Stephanie, is this your first lunch?
Yeah, it is.
So what do you think?
I think this is fabulous.
Let's hear it for the ladies who lunch. Everybody
Now, despite the name, the women are not required to take off their wigs at these lunches. And the group of gals I met were very open about it. But Thea wants everyone to know that wigs or no wigs, any woman with alopecia is welcome to join them. And we posted some more information about Bald Girls Do Lunch on our website, todayshow.com. But Natalie, they were a brave group of women and just full of life and spirit. And they
such
were
positive attitude.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
They said, we're healthy and we're happy.
And they
could be a lot worse.
And they look great. I have to say, bald is beautiful.
It is.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much,
sure.
Amy.